destined to our ship and go a different direction. So as we learn from the great love of God, the love that is as big as the ocean you are seeing around, we will be doing our lesson and our ministry from the boat. So in a short while, I will be on the boat, we'll be getting on the boat to see how men have run away from God and how gracious God is to forgive. The same way he forgave Jonah, we will learn from that. And the same way God can speak to you even in the belly of the fish. The best way to understand it is when we are right on the waters where Jonah was supposed to die. God forgave him and gave him a chance to speak again to the Ninevites. And I believe that you'll also be able to pick a lesson and repent and also be used of God to bring a change to the lives of people. So I want to invite you to tune up with me as we get into the deeper lessons of the love of God to those who are running away from ministry and to the people who are supposed to die. And then God gave them a chance to live again, the Ninevites. So stay tuned, and I believe that the Lord will bless you as we get this lesson from the boat. Amen and amen. We honor you, we give you glory, Lord. Yes, we honor you, you are wonderful, you are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful, you are worthy, oh Lord. We give you glory, we give you glory, Lord. As we honor you, we give you glory, Lord. As we honor you, you are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. 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 Hallelujah. We give you glory, Lord. We praise your name, Jehovah. You are worthy of our praise. You are worthy of the glory. You are worthy of the honor. Great is your faithfulness, O Lord. We decree the honor of your name, the majesty that is due your name, O God. We thank you today as we get in your presence. Your presence is all over, upon the earth, in the waters, above in the heavens. Your presence is there, down in the depth of the sea. Your presence is there, Lord. Enormous is your love. And today we give you praise and we give you glory and honor and majesty because you are God. I pray that you bless us today as we fellowship in your word. And I pray that your spirit will minister to us in the name of Jesus. We thank you for this new day, a day full of mercies and full of your grace. Use us this day, Lord, for your own glory as we look into the ministry of your word, and that your name will be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I want to bless the Lord for the privilege he has given us to see the day and to be in his presence. It is a joy to see the ocean and to see the waters. And like I've already said in our introduction, we still are looking at the forgiving grace, the grace of God in forgiving sin. God is known for forgiving sin. And I want to read the word of God from the book of Jonah, chapter number 3. I'll read a verse number 10. The Bible says in the book of Jonah, chapter number 3, verse number 10, then God saw their works, But they turned from their evil way, and God relented from the disaster that he had said he would bring upon them, and he did not do it. I'll read again. Then God saw their works, but they turned from their evil way, and God relented from the disaster that he had said he would bring upon them. He did not do it. May the Lord bless the reading of the word. God loves everybody. Amen. God loves everybody. Even the people we hate, they belong to God. Even the people whom the very chosen people of Israel hated, like the Syrians, the love of God is so big. I'll be talking about the riches of God's love. God is so rich in love. God is so rich in kindness. His love is unending and it's so big. The love of God is as big as the waters that we are seeing around. You cannot measure the love of God. He loves those who are his, and he even loves the rebellious. God loves even the rebellious. And I will tell you that even the Saul, the murderer, he was part of God's plan that one day he will become an apostle. There are people you cannot imagine God can forgive. There are people whom even the preachers, the prophets, will want to run away from. But still, God loves these groups of people. And that makes or informs my message today. The very people you even hate to preach to, those people can still be loved of God. And the only point here is this. If they turn away from their sins, however deep in sin they may have been, God is so gracious enough to forgive them. And it's a good lesson for us to learn from God that he can forgive anybody. Even the most rebellious, your very son who is so deep in drugs, who has spoiled the family name, who is the reject of the family, when visitors come, he wants to hide that son. He can still turn and become a symbol of glory in that family. God loves the rejects. God loves the people, the unloved of the society. God loves them. And he wanted to see and to bring that lesson into being by picking on Jonah, a man whom God raised to be an evangelist in the territory of the enemies of Israel, the Syrians, the people who were the enemies of Israel. And God picks on Jonah because he knew the heart of Jonah would give us a lesson for us to learn from. And he tells Jonah, I want you to go to Nineveh, the city of the Syrians, and tell them that their sins have come before me and terror will come against them. And you know, because Jonah hated to see anything good come to the Syrians, number one, he rejected the call of God and he got into the sea. I said in the introduction that he got into the sea to run away from the message of God. And I'm here to tell that preacher man, that preacher woman that is watching this message, are you the Jonah of today? God has sent you to preach the message of the gospel, but you are running away. You are in a boat or in a sea like I am today, and you are moving in the direction God doesn't want you to move. Can you imagine the mess Jonah brought to the people? A beautiful boat like this, sinking because somebody has refused the call of God. Jonah refused and he got into the boat. He got into a ship headed for a different direction. And God is rich in grace and mercy. And you know, he gave Jonah a second chance. You know it from the scriptures. It didn't work. The ship refused to go. And the people of the boat, like my brothers who are here, if their mission to go to their business will not be accomplished because I'm running away from them, the mission of God, they cannot allow it. They to check to know, why are things not working? Why is our ship, which is not faulty, not going the direction it's supposed to go? And after a short assessment, they discovered the alien is Jonah, whom they investigated, and they got to understand he was a Hebrew serving the Hebrew God, who is a great God. And Jonah opened up and he said, it is me, the reason why things are not working in this ship. At the end of it all, they threw Jonah into the sea. I'll not be thrown today because I'm only preaching on Jonah. Come on. We need to understand it. I'll not be thrown today because I'm preaching the gospel of peace. And so Jonah was in the sea. and in the sea thrown because of his rebellion. He doesn't want the Ninevites to get saved. He doesn't want the people of Syria to get saved. And many of us, we even hate the people God can love. We hate to see some people get saved. That very neighbor who disturbs you when you see people preaching to them, you hate to see it because, you know, you don't want them to get saved. Jonah was like that. But in the belly of the sea, in the belly of the fish, Jonah turned to God. And I will tell you that conversion was a halfway. In as much as he cried to God and God had mercy on him, and a fish came and swallowed him, and Jonah is given a free trip, not in a ship now, a free trip in the bottom of the fish, and is taken to Nineveh. While in Nineveh, Jonah begins a ministry. Jonah Ministries International, if I have to put it like that. Jonah Ministries International. And he begins with the people that were on the shore. He begins to preach under an anointing. He preaches the message of the gospel under an anointing. He begins with the fishermen, the wicked people who are on the beach. You know how people behave on the beach. And even in Kenya, we know, and other nations of the world, people are naked on the beach. And I will tell you, those of us who are always naked on the beach, God will judge you for your nakedness. You have to behave right. We should not sell our bodies so cheaply. Jonah began with such like a people, and he preached to them. And from the people at the seashore to the president, to the king of the land, they turned to God. So the scripture says, after God saw their works, that even the king, to the lowest person in the land, they repented. They listened to the message of Jonah. And I'm preaching to somebody today. God is a forgiving God. If there can only be a seed of repentance, if there can only be a turnaround in the heart of men, God is a forgiving God. I'm preaching the message of forgiveness. Forgiveness was given us in Christ. And I want to say this, Jesus died before Adam was created. He was the lamb that was slain before the foundation of time. Jesus was in God, you see, interceding for the Ninevites. Even when Jonah doesn't love the Ninevites, Jesus was in God interceding for them. And when God looks at these people who changed their behavior, who put on sackcloth and started to repent, God forgave them. And I want to move to my next verse because it's important. And this is in verse number 1, chapter number 4 of Jonah. When God forgives the Ninevites, the Bible says, and what God did upset Jonah. He upset, he was upset. He felt bad, he has preached. The entire city and nation has turned to God. But the Bible says, and Jonah is upset. He is upset that God has not destroyed the people. He is upset that God has not destroyed. His intention was, I will preach, but they will not get saved. I will preach, but they will not repent. He was preaching, but in the inside of him, he didn't want these people to be changed. He didn't want these people, you know, he wanted the wrath of God to get to them. He was like, let me preach, wash my hands, but God will come and destroy them. But they changed. And I'm here to say to somebody, the very people we think cannot change, they will change. Even Rahab, the harlot, changed. Anybody can get saved. Anybody can change. The robbers we see today, I see them becoming the preachers of tomorrow. The harlotry we see in women today, and even in men, I see a big harvest in the latter days. I'm here to tell the people of God, prepare to see the notorious sinners turning to the kingdom of God. Jesus never came for those who are righteous. He came for sinners. He came for people like those of Nineveh. He came for people like John, like Paul when he was Saul. And so it upset Jonah. And Jonah is like, no, God, you are wrong. Why save such like a people? You are not supposed to be saved. He was upset. But I want to say this. Why is Jonah upset? Because he was looking for his own personal interests, not the interests in the heart of God. But the Bible talks about something very powerful, God's loving kindness. God's loving kindness. And that is where my message will also emphasize, God's loving kindness. You cannot measure the love of God. In fact, one nation cannot exhaust the love of God. Israel alone cannot exhaust the love of God. It's too much. It is as big as this ocean you see around. If you see somebody blessed and they are millionaires, don't envy them. There is still too much in God. There is still enough in God for you. There is still enough in God. We should not envy those who prosper. We can also prosper. There is too much in God, and that is my message again. Why should Jonah be upset, and God is not borrowing from Jonah to forgive the Ninevites? God has enough love. He has enough love for Israel. He has enough love to save the Ninevites. I'm here to say we have to repent. Anybody who feels like I didn't have a room in my father's house, there is enough room in the father's house. His love is enormous. Amen. The love of God is so big. It has a place for Israel and it has a place for Ninevites. The love of God is so big. It is so, so big. Enough for the Ninevites and enough for the Israelites. I'll read Jonah chapter 4 verse number 1. The Bible says, but it displeased Jonah exceedingly, and he became angry. So he prayed to the Lord and said, Ah, Lord, was not this what I said when I was still in my country? Therefore I fled previously to Tarshish, for I know that you are a gracious and merciful God, slow to anger and abundant in loving kindness, one who relents from doing harm. Therefore now, Lord, please take my life from me, for it is better for me to die than live. Jonah, after seeing God forgive the Ninevites, he wants to die because God has loved them. He says, God, your anger is too slow. He thought God would come before they change and kill them. But God is slow in anger. And I want to say this message is also in Exodus chapter 34, verse number 6. God is so gracious. God is so compassionate. God is a forgiving God. I want to share with Kenya. I want to share with the nations of the world. God is gracious. God is compassionate. And if we will have God in our hearts, we will not struggle to forgive the notorious sinners, the people who grieved us the most. That is my message this week. Look for the very person who grieved you the most and borrow this love God has in his heart. Let that love come in our hearts. We can forgive the people we hate the most. We can love them. We can give them food. The Bible says, love your enemies, and when they don't have food, give them food. God has a mercy and a grace that is immeasurable. And this is what wants to kill Jonah. He wants to die because his enemies have gotten saved. His enemies have been spared. Am I talking to somebody who is angry because others are rising? Am I talking to somebody who is angry because your enemies are blessed? Am I talking to somebody who is angry because the very person you are ahead of in school, the one who was performing poorly, he has risen and is now prospering? Can I tell you, he's not prospering because of anything. God is the one who blesses people. He can change the direction of things. He can still bless the people we do not expect him to bless. God had mercy on the Ninevites. God forgave the Ninevites, and Jonah is hurt. And he's still talking to God and he's telling God, I knew you were slow to anger. I knew you would still forgive these people. May we change from that attitude. That is my prayer. May we change from the Jonah attitude. God would have allowed the fish to digest Jonah. If God was that kind, he would have allowed the fish to digest Jonah. And I'm praying that you and me, the fish of life, the fish, the sicknesses, the poverty that is sweeping people, will not be that fish which will digest us, because we are thinking God is like us. God is so gracious. If he was to judge men, he would have started with Jonah. But God is gracious. He does not begin with judgment. He begins with grace. Even the people we hate the most, God is gracious on them. And that is what Jesus came to do. He ate with the sinners. He ate with, you know, people like Zacchaeus, who was extortioners, they were stealing from people. And they are the very people Jesus uses, the very people Jesus would dine with. And God is that gracious. So why did God forgive the Ninevites? The Bible says he is so rich in mercy and grace. I want to speak to somebody today. Your case is repairable. You can still be forgiven. I don't know what you did until you feel, nobody can accept me. Men may not accept you, but God is gracious. God will accept you. Some of you think your children are beyond repair. They cannot turn to the kingdom. Continue praying for them. God's mercy will get to them. If God forgave Nineveh, God will forgive your children. God will forgive your wife. Maybe you married a wife and she is always in harlotry. She is going out of the marriage bounds. I know it, there is a permission in the Bible that adultery can lead to divorce, but divorce should be the last resort. However adulterous or however a husband may be, somebody born of God can still believe God and they change and save a life. Can I preach to somebody? We need to borrow from the grace of God. We need to borrow from the forgiveness that God has in his heart. If God forgave a murderer in the name of Saul, if God forgave people in the Bible who are sinners of sinners, he can forgive anybody. And he can also use us as agents of forgiveness. I pray that I'll not be like Jonah. I pray that you'll not be like Jonah. I pray that you'll carry the message of forgiveness. And today, I want to crown my message on forgiveness by saying, may we understand how big God's love is. He is rich in mercy. He is rich in grace. And from the riches of his grace, we find forgiveness. I'll read one more scripture on how gracious God is so that he is able to forgive. God is rich in mercy. Ephesians chapter number 1, verse number 7. Ephesians chapter number 1, verse number 7. Hallelujah. The Bible says, in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace. Forgiveness comes from the riches. To be rich, it's like somebody who has a billion or billions of shillings on their account. They are not troubled when they withdraw some millions because they have trillions. When God forgives a sinner, it does not move him because his heart is rich in grace. And I pray that God will give us to be rich in grace in our hearts so that we forgive the people we hate. Today I pray, reduce the number of the people you hate on the list. You might be having 20 people on a list you have put in a red color. You say, these ones, no. I am urging you by the mercies of God, forgive them. Begin to believe God to forgive them. Remove them from your heart. Let us behave like the way God wants us to behave. God is expecting that because he's gracious on us, we will be gracious on other people. And the scriptures say, forgive and you'll be forgiven. My message today is this, brethren and people of God. Forgive and you'll be forgiven. When you sow the seed of forgiveness, you will reap forgiveness. I don't know where you will mess tomorrow. And will you expect God to forgive you? I don't know where you will go astray tomorrow. If you go astray, will you expect people to pardon you? If you are waiting for people to pardon you, begin to pardon people today. Make up your mind today and forgive somebody. Make up your mind today. Don't behave like Jonah. He is upset because God has forgiven people, yet God is gracious. Yet God is merciful. We need to change our mind and begin to forgive. I will finish by saying, forgiveness is by grace. It is the grace of God. An ordinary carnal man cannot forgive. A man led by the flesh and blood cannot forgive. The best a carnal man will give is anger and wrath. That is why we pray that the blood of Jesus will clean anger from us, will clean wrath from us, that we may portray Jesus, that we may be messengers of hope, that we'll be messengers of forgiveness and give out the love of God. Today, if you only allow God to move through you, you will be able to forgive somebody. I'm praying in the name of Jesus, let there be forgiveness in that family. Let there be forgiveness in that place of work. Let there be forgiveness in that company. God is forgiving, but he can forgive through you. God is forgiving. He will forgive through you. May the Spirit of grace produce the fruit of forgiveness in you. I pray that the Spirit of grace will produce forgiveness in me. Regardless of how many people have hurt you, there is room for forgiveness. If God forgave them in heavens, God can forgive anybody. And if God is that kind of a forgiver, we will also forgive. So today I want to say this. The Lord wants us to forgive. And forgiveness opens the door for the grace of God, for the love of God. That is why God allowed Jonah to sit under Satan branch, and after a short while he dried the branch. And when Jonah begins to complain, why have you dried the branch, God told him, why did you complain that I had mercy on the Ninevites? I'm sustaining you because you allowed me to use you. If we will only allow God to use us, our provision will remain. If we will only allow God to use us through forgiveness, your business will not close. Allow God to use you through forgiveness, and your children will never go hungry. Our heavenly doors will remain open because we are agents of forgiveness. I will say this, and I said it in the course of the week. The only way to be different from non-believers is to forgive. Non-believers still use the law of Moses. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. But we are different. We are carriers of Jesus. Where we are hurt, let's pray through the night. You can pray and fast and tell God, give me grace to forgive my enemy. Give me grace to forgive my supervisor, my boss in the place of work, my wife, my children, the people that have given you sleepless night. May God give us grace to forgive them. Why? Because he is rich in grace and mercy. Forgiveness comes from mercy, and forgiveness comes from grace. And today, before I close my service, I want to pray for grace. I want to believe God for the grace of forgiveness. If you want to be a great leader in life, you will meet so many disappointments. Have a big heart. You want to be a great husband. You want to be a great woman of God in your family. You want to be a leader of your family. Be willing. Give room for people to hurt you. And when they hurt you, you are willing to make peace by forgiving them. I want to believe God for the grace of forgiveness. As huge as this ocean is, may the love of God be that big in us. Be as big as God in the inside of you, that you are able to carry millions of people in your heart, even your enemies. A president in a country is a president for the opposition and for the government. May God raise you to be a king so that you can also feed the opposition. It is you who is feeding the opposition. That is the grace of God. You know there is an enemy called Judas on the table, and the very Judas is the man you give food. May God give you the grace that was in Christ Jesus. The grace to forgive, the grace to live with your enemies, and God will provide and God will protect us. I want to lead somebody to that prayer, but before we pray the prayer for the grace of forgiveness, maybe you are in sin. You are like the Ninevites. You have not given your life to Jesus. You are not born again. There is grace. If God forgave the Ninevites who are frustrating Israel, God can forgive any sin. The only way is this. Believe in your heart that Jesus, through whom we have forgiveness, through whom we have redemption, Jesus who died on the cross, believe in him. In your heart believe that he died and resurrected. And with your mouth confess that he is Lord, and he will be Lord over your life. If you are that kind of a person, I want you to pray this prayer after me, the prayer of repentance. And God will forgive you the way he forgave me. Say these words after me. Say, Jesus, I come to you. I'm a sinner. I repent my sins. Forgive me and accept me as your very own. From today, I belong to you. I change my ways. Thank you for loving me and for accepting me. Amen. If you pray that prayer, you are born again. You are a child of God. The same way God forgave them in heavens, he has forgiven you. Begin to love him and receive that forgiveness and give it out. I want to pray for the rest of the people watching this clip, and you are like Jonah, the very people you hate. You see, God has loved them and you don't want to extend that love to them. You don't want to forgive them. I want to pray with somebody who has a list of so many people who grieved them. I want to pray with that husband who is struggling to love the wife because she messed up your money. She spent your money wrongly and you are thinking of marrying another one. The other one you want to marry will mess it the more. It is easy to forgive the one you have than to look for another one who will even rob you. May we repent and may we have a chance for the people who wronged us in their hearts. Can I pray for you who is struggling in your heart to forgive somebody? That will open your door. That will change your circumstance. In the name of Jesus, Father, I pray for those viewing. Anybody that has struggled in their hearts to forgive. Lord, anybody who blocked their doors by refusing to forgive, I pray that you give us the grace to forgive. I destroy the chains, the bondage, anchor, and rage in the hearts of men. I pray it will be broken in this season and time, in this difficult time. Anybody who has given themselves to be a slave of anger, Lord, I pray that spirit is being broken in the name of Jesus. And I pray, oh God, help us to be a men and women who will communicate for forgiveness to our society. May you help us to forgive, because after we forgive, then you will also forgive us, oh God. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. I believe God has given you a grace to forgive somebody. Right now, before I close, I won't give you a chance. You have an issue, you want God to sort it out. I believe together with you on this boat, a miracle will come your way. There is an anointing on this boat. You are in any kind of trouble, you are sick in your body, you have challenges, financial or whichever. I want to prophesy over your life in Jesus' name. Father, I prophesy to your people. They have been patient to watch. They have been patient to wait and listen to your word. May you meet with their needs. Those who are sick, I bind that sickness in Jesus' name. Those who have any other challenge, I decree a solution is coming their way. Be glorified and be magnified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. I believe you've been blessed. I believe that your life will never be the same. My parting shot is this. Don't be like Jonah. We don't want you to mess up with other people's businesses by sinking their boats because you are going the wrong direction. Accept the ministry of forgiveness. Take it to the people and your life will have peace. There is a number on your screen. You have a seed or you have an offering to give. This is a Sunday service. You want to serve God. There is a number running on your screen. You can pay your tithe if you are part of our church. And if you can sow a seed in this ministry for the purposes of the gospel, go ahead and the Lord will bless you. Can I pray for you as you serve the Lord with your offering? Father, I pray that you bless your people as they serve you with their offering. Those who are paying their tithe, I rebuke the devourer on your behalf, of God, for them. And I pray that you heal their lives and their businesses. We give you praise and glory. Thank you for this gracious time that you have given us in your presence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Okay, the Lord bless you. It has been a blessing to have you on board in the ministry of the word. The Lord bless you as we keep enjoying the breeze in the presence of God. The Lord bless you. Meet next time in Jesus' name. Amen.